Hello, guys. Even though on screen I will be doing makeup, in voiceover I will be answering some really personal questions, tackling all kinds of different subjects between life, demisexuality, regrets, things like that. Before I dive into these questions, I'm just going to put on some jewelry before even doing my makeup. So I've had Ana Luisa jewelry on in a bunch of other videos in the past. I'm sure some of you have noticed. For those of you who don't know, Ana Luisa is a sustainable jewelry company. They use premium materials and everything is very long-lasting. They're officially carbon neutral. I really love what they stand for. They really just want to give back to our planet. Their prices are really affordable. Their starting price point is $39. I got a few new pieces that I wanted to show you guys. I haven't had an ear cuff in a while, but I always try to look for one that's a good quality, which I can never find. This one is honestly so good. It kind of gives me like that kind of edgy feeling. I don't know, maybe I'm just weird. It looks feminine, but also has a little bit of an edge to it. This one is probably my favorite piece out of all of them. I also got this Mecca off-white ring, which is fully adjustable. I think it's actually really flattering. I don't have a ring like this, and I can put it on any finger, except maybe my pinky finger. I don't know, I haven't tried that yet. But I could put it on any finger, and it fits, and it doesn't slip or slide. I was eyeing these Cassie earrings because of how amazing they look on the model, and I just really wanted a style of earring that was like that, kind of unique. I actually didn't end up wearing these while filming this video just because it had been a while since I've consistently worn earrings, so my piercing wasn't very big, so that's something to note for some of you guys. It just takes a bit of patience to put them in, but they are stunning. So of course, these earrings that I have on now are a pair that I've had before. You guys have seen them in other videos. In case you wanted to know which earrings they are, these ones are called Celeste. It's a star and a crescent moon. So I'll put a link to the Ana Luisa site for you guys if you wanted to go check them out and pick out a few pieces for yourself. How are you feeling about life right now? How's your mental health? It's been up and down. Lately it's been much better since I've been actually in self-isolation these last couple of days. So I've had time to kind of just be with myself and not be in the grind of life, and that has helped. A lot of the times I feel a lot of pressure with all the things that I have to juggle, and I think a lot of people can definitely relate to that. So juggling a full-time job, auditions, which have been coming up a lot more in the last month and a half, and filming videos, thinking of content to film, pre-planning things, personal life, everything, just juggling it all, it can really overwhelm me, and I haven't really had a full time to just stop and breathe. Even now, even self-isolated, I'm still continuously working on things. So it's still a work in progress. I have to be kinder to myself, which I'm not always, and my anxiety has been up and down. Yeah, it's just, remember that I can't do a billion things in one shot. I have to just, you know, breathe sometimes. And when I'm calmer, then I don't get as much anxiety attacks or intrusive thoughts or anything like that, compulsions or anything. Life has been fine. There have been their ups and downs, and that's okay. I'm okay with that. It's just part of life, and I'm coping in the best way that I possibly can in this moment in time. Something that has really helped me during COVID or when I'm feeling really anxious about things is actually exercising regularly. When I eat better, it helps. When I have time to plan things. I'm a heavy planner, so I need to make sure everything is organized in my brain or else I will freak out. So having a planner around just to know what the next thing I need to do is, that has been very helpful. And being able to talk about it and Yeah, those have been very helpful for me. What do you regret? I wish that I took language classes more serious, and I wish that I saw the major importance in them, especially when it comes to family. Something that I regret is not continuously practicing my French. So my dad is French, and I grew up with the language as a child, and I went to French schools and, you know, was surrounded by the language, but I was always really self-conscious of speaking French. I would gravitate to just speaking in English. And now, since I've been removed from high school for so long, that I'm starting to lose a big portion of my French, and I've been trying to just kind of get it back and develop my French more. It's still a struggle, but I'm trying my best to get myself to speak French more to my dad so that I can properly have conversations with my grandma. Her English isn't the greatest, so that's the main language she converses in. Why has your content changed? Well, it's part of growing up, I guess. I started off my channel doing a lot of Harry Potter videos, and it was really hard to keep up with. It was hard to think of videos. I felt stuck in one niche, and I didn't want to be stuck in one niche. It's not that I hate making Harry Potter videos and doing magical things like that, but like life, you grow, and I just wanted my channel to be more of me and less of one thing. Even though Harry Potter is a story that I love, despite some of the controversy going on with the writer, which I was not happy about, which was another reason why I wanted to step back a little bit, but it is a story that holds near and dear to my heart, but it isn't the only thing that I hold near and dear, and I really wanted to incorporate especially voice acting, and I really wanted to incorporate any type of videography. I don't know, I just wanted to show my life more and share my life more, and that's why my content has changed a little bit. Not saying I will never do Potter content in the future, but as of right now, I am content with where my channel is headed. What made you gravitate towards acting? Originally, I actually started off as a dancer, and that kind of just like fell away after a while. I gravitated towards performing arts because I was a very shy kid. I was really quiet. Like, if you guys think of the quietest person you know, I was probably more quiet than that. And it could have something to do with the fact that I was born with a twin, and we basically just, you know, stayed together and would only talk to each other, and other people were just kind of scary to us. And acting was a way for me to be able to express myself without being afraid. It's still that way for me, actually. Even though I'm not as quiet as I was when I was a child, I still have my moments where I'm shy, but I'm not as quiet as I was then, but I still have moments where I have a hard time expressing how I really feel about something, and especially acting gives me permission to be as mad or as sad as I want to be and not get in trouble for it, and not have someone scold me for it or tell me that I can't feel that way or I shouldn't feel that way. It gives me free permission to just kind of express myself, and I think that's why I gravitated towards especially acting. How's it being demisexual in a relationship? Well, I think that being demisexual in a relationship, at least for me, I would imagine it's not so different than being in a relationship with two people who are not demisexual. But being in a long distance relationship and demisexual, I think, is a little bit different. For me, it's kind of tricky because if I'm not having connected conversation with my partner, if it's just like, how's your day, how's work, if it's more small talk based, then it can be challenging for me. So when I don't feel fully connected, or there's like that you're not sharing moments or like this bond, I can feel very disconnected. And it doesn't mean that I love or care about my partner any less. It's just, you know, it's just how my body is. I just don't feel any sexual feelings. I don't feel like, yeah, I just don't feel those feelings. But when I have connected conversations and I feel that bond and I feel, you know, I feel very bonded to my partner, then, you know, those feelings can come up. Yeah, it's definitely dependent on connection for me. And yes, that's kind of a thing I feel in general with partners in person. Like, if there's no connection going on, I feel absolutely nothing. But yeah, that's basically, I don't know if that makes any sense or not. So yeah, it has a lot to do with connection and feeling bonded for any kind of sexual attraction to form within my body. So that's how it's been, at least for me. Something you look forward to in the future. There are lots of things I look forward to. Like, I really look forward to getting a pet, mainly because I just miss having an animal around, a pet around. Just, you know, they just fill your heart up and they just make every day a little adventure, and they're funny and adorable. A cute little companion, that's nice. In general, I just kind of look forward to a calmer life. I look forward to less paranoia. I'm looking forward to a life where I can feel a bit more at peace with things and feel more comfortable in my own body and just be happier with my career and where my life is at. That I really look forward to. So that's it for this video today. I hope this was a nice calming video for you to listen to. And if you guys related to anything that I was saying, then, you know, share your thoughts in the comment section. I love hearing from all of you guys and your wonderful stories. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, and don't forget to check out Ana Luisa's site if you want to get some nice, pretty, minimalistic jewelry. Yeah, share this video and don't forget to subscribe if you are new to my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Much love, guys. Bye.